With React Native, developers who know React can create native mobile apps for Android and iOS. The advantage here is that you have a single code base. Hence, you only need to write common features once. Now, what is the recommended way for creating apps with React Native in 2025 and beyond? React Native recommends using a framework. A framework is like a toolbox with all the necessary tools and APIs that you need for building your apps for production. Particularly, React Native recommends using the Expo framework. Expo comes with a file-based routing system which will enable you to manage navigation within your application. It also comes with some universal React Native libraries. Also, it has plugins that will enable you to manage the native code without actually touching the native files. Now, an optional Expo application services is also available. These are a set of services that will help you in your app development process. The services include generating builds for your application, submitting them to the stores, and also updating them. Now let's talk about using Expo the recommended way. Now this will be a high level overview, but I will link to in-depth videos as we progress. First of all, you need an Expo based project. Creating the project is as simple as going to your command line and using the NPS create Expo app command to create a new project. This requires you to have a version of Node.js installed, in particular a long-term support one. I have a very old video on the channel in which we installed Node.js and set up the whole development for Expo. I'll link to it here so that you can check it out if you want to know how the Node.js installation works. With our project ready, we need to set up our development environment. This will be our local development setup of platforms and devices that we will use for building and running the project. We have the main aspect covered already, that is our PC. So that can be a macOS, Windows or Linux based machine. Since we are building a mobile app, our main output device for monitoring will be a mobile device or smartphone. Over here, a real mobile device is recommended as you see exactly what your users will see when the application is ready. So if you are interested in developing with an Android, you need to get a Samsung, Google Pixel or any device along that line running Android. If you're interested in iOS, then you need to get an iPhone. Now we have other less ideal alternatives. These include using Android emulators or iOS simulators. The availability of these depends on the platform your PC is running. Starting with the Android emulator, this will work regardless of the platform, so it will work on Windows, macOS, and Linux. Now this requires you to have Android Studio installed. In the Android Studio, you need to download a version of the Android OS. Also, you need SDK build tools for Android and also download the Android emulator itself. After this, you also need to set the Android SDK location as an environment variable. Once you have the Android setup, you can create the emulator under your virtual device manager. Here, you select the hardware of your choice and also the OS you downloaded. For this step as well, I'll link to the old setup video that I mentioned. We went through the process of installing Android Studio in that video, so you can check it out if you want. The other alternative we have here is the iOS simulator. For this, you can only access it on macOS, so you need a MacBook for this to work. Accessing this is quite simple. The only thing you need to install is Xcode and also Xcode command line tools. Lastly, you need to install Watchman using the homebrew command line tool. Now with the platforms and devices out of the way, we need to choose how we would like to develop. The quickest way to get started is by using the Expo Go app. The Expo Go app is a limited sandbox which comes pre-installed with libraries that are commonly used in building basic apps. This will enable you to quickly prototype and develop your app. However, this does not support any custom native modules, and it's only great for testing out Expo quickly. Hence, it's not intended for long-term or production projects. How do you get this Expo app set up and running? If you are working with an emulator or the iOS simulator, After starting a dev server for your project, you need to press I or A to open the iOS simulator or the Android emulator. This will run through the process of installing the Expo Go app on the emulator, and once it's done, it will open the project automatically. If you are working with an actual device, you have to go to the Apple App Store or Google Play Store. Here, you can search for Expo Go and install it. Once you have that, you can start your development server once again and scan the QR code that is provided to open your project in the Expo Go app. Now you can proceed to develop your app. We've seen the quickest way, but what is the recommended way? The recommended approach is to make use of development builds. Development builds are customized builds of your own application with developer tools and just the native code that you need to run the specific React Native app that you are developing. Hence, this supports the use of custom native models and it's intended for production projects. Now, how do you get it? It starts by making the custom build in your project. There are two ways to do this. The first approach is to do this locally on your PC. This requires you to install a version of the OpenJava SDK among other packages. You are also required to install Expo Dev Client in the project. And once you have this, you can run the project for your platform to generate the build, and then you can install it on the device. To be able to build for both iOS and Android, you will need a macOS. Otherwise, you can only build for Android. Now, the second approach is to use EAS build from Expo Application Services. With this approach being cloud-based, you can use it regardless of the platform of your PC. Using this involves installing EAS CLI as a global package. Now, you need to log in with a valid Expo account. After this, you need to configure the project for the development build. This will add an auto-generated JSON file to your project. We don't need to do anything to this file, unless you are planning to run the build on an iOS simulator. If that's the case, inside the file and under the development profile, you need to add the iOS key. Under this key, you then have to specify simulator and set the value to true. Now, the build can be created using the EAS build command. Here, you specify the platform to be either Android or iOS, and then you specify the profile to be development. If you are planning to use the build on the Android emulator or the iOS emulator, once the build is completed, you have a prompt on the command line. You can confirm this prompt by pressing Y to download and install the build on your emulator. If you don't have access to the prompt, you can download the build from the link and drag and drop it onto the emulator to install it. If you are working with an Android device, all you need to do is to scan the QR code in the terminal. This will take you to a page where you can download the APK file and open it to install it once it's done. For the iOS device, a few more steps are required. The first thing you need to do is to enroll in the Apple Developer Program. This is a very crucial step in the process. Once you have this, before you even run the EAS build command to create the build, you need to register your device. So you create a device on the command line to register it, and then you can proceed to run the build command. Now, this will require you to turn on developer mode on the device, and this is hidden in settings under privacy, and then you can enable developer mode. Once you've done this, the phone will require a restart, then you can confirm and then enter your passcode. Once the build is completed, you can scan the generated QR code to open the app with iTunes, and then it will be installed on your device. Now, at this point, regardless of the device that you used, you should have a project and then a development environment ready. The app installed on your device is the customized build we are talking about. Now you can start the development server for the project and then scan the QR code to open the project in your app, and then you can start developing. Now, this was a high-level overview of the recommended way to build React Native apps. The first video linked here will give you an in-depth demonstration on how to create the development build using EAS build. The second video goes in depth on how to use such builds when developing.